These attributes also support doing a kind of a tree structure of their own. You can create child attributes. So for example, let me create a brand new attribute, and I'm just going to call this one specs. So this is going to be all the specifications, and that specifications would be something that has a lot of child attributes associated with it. And those child attributes can have their own child attributes as well. So for example, let's do a new child attribute here. We'll call this the, the width. And then in addition, let's add something. Let's say the manufacturer. So all of these are the different child attributes, and they of course can, in addition, have in addition to their attributes themselves, they can have additional child attributes themselves. So let's see, this might be the manufacturer's location, or in addition, let's say this is his cost code. So all of these are things that can attain this kind of a tree structure because of the support within the attributes themselves for parents and children. Now, this is not really analogous to what we're doing within elements. Within elements, if you remember, we were supporting drag and drop, etc. You can have these things in such a way that they had specific relationships, strong, weak, or composition, etc. No such options within here. Now, the one option that we do have that we haven't really discussed yet is you can categorize these attributes. You can also categorize elements. We'll talk more about categories in general later on.